Let's continue with the last part of this introduction to URDF and Zagreb. We've already seen that URDF is used to model robots and environments in ROS, and that to address some of the shortcomings of URDF, we can use Zagreb. But ROS also comes with a small set of tools that can help us when working with URDF. In this video, we'll take a quick look at a program called CheckURDF, which, as the name implies, is a tool that can load a URDF file for us and verify whether it is legal, or in other words, whether we've made any mistakes when writing our URDF file. One important thing to keep in mind, though, is that CheckURDF can only check whether we're using legal combinations of URDF tags. It cannot know whether you have correctly configured the joint limits for a particular joint, nor can it determine whether the total mass of your robot corresponds to what the manufacturer specifies. Technically, we say that in these cases, CheckURDF only checks the syntax of URDF, but not the semantics. That sounds like a serious limitation, but even just checking syntax can already save you quite some time. Let's look at an example. This is the same URDF that we saw earlier. It is the really simple robot with only two links and a joint, but I've introduced an error in it. Can you spot it? Notice how the child link of joint 1 is set to link 3 instead of link 2. There is obviously no link 3, and this is an obvious mistake, but it's only an example. In real-world applications, URDFs can be many thousands of lines long, and spotting such a small typo is not at all easy in those cases. Let's run CheckURDF on this URDF. We can do so with the following command, and this gives us the following output. Complaining that it can't find link 3, which is specified as being the name of the child of joint 1. Now, obviously, this is exactly what we expected. This is easy to fix. So let's change the value for the child link back from link 3 to link 2 again. And rerunning CheckURDF with the exact same command now returns success, which is again what we expected, seeing as we fixed the mistake. Now, those of you paying attention may have noticed that the tool is called CheckURDF, which sort of implies that it can only check URDFs. And that's true. The Zagreb files that we discussed in the previous video would seem to be incompatible. And they are if we try to pass them directly to CheckURDF, but not if we first use the Zagreb program to convert them to URDF and then pass that file. So the first step is to convert the Zagreb to URDF, like so. And then we pass that to CheckURDF. Unfortunately, we cannot directly pipe the output of Zagreb to CheckURDF, and we must use the intermediate file. But at least this way, we can check the URDF for errors. And also, unfortunately, but there is no tool available for checking Zagreb files directly. So it's up to you to map the problems CheckURDF finds to their Zagreb origins. And this brings us to the end of this three-part presentation on an introduction to URDF and Zagreb. Both are powerful tools for modeling worlds and robots in ROS, but both also have their weaknesses. And even in small models, mistakes are easily made. Fortunately, ROS provides us with a tool that can help us make sure our URDFs are legal and free of mistakes. It only checks syntax, not semantics, but even that can already be very helpful. Finally, CheckURDF really only checks URDF files, so Zagreb will need to be converted before they can be checked. Make sure to take a look at some of the exercises on the course page, and let's continue with some more hands-on work in the next videos.